Welcome to the special broadcast from the Tribune Network. I'm Rohit Bhan. Today we are discussing a very important story which is broken by the Tribune today, a story on the lopsided distribution of teachers in Punjab schools. Imagine 226 students and there's not even a single teacher for a school in Punjab. And on the other hand, a school which has probably not more than 20 students and 9 teachers posted there. We are joined by Sanjeev who broke this story today. Sanjeev, please explain to us, you know, why this lopsided, uneven distribution of teachers?
The basic issue involved is that Punjab does not have a transfer policy for teachers. It never was in place, which has resulted in a situation that some schools are without teachers and some have many. The schools that have many teachers, no one wants to go, and they have been neglected. So this has led to a big gap. This largely is the big reason, and it's quite a big number.
And given the fact that, you know, there's uneven distribution, how much does it impact the quality of education? Of course, when there's no teacher, obviously what to speak of the kind of education that will be imparted. How much does it impact the quality of education?
Well, teaching in government schools as such is impacted even minus this, because there is also a category of government schools like one in Mia village in Sangrur district where there are about 20 students and about 4-5 teachers, but no one wants to put their child in a government school because parents are so rebuffed. Parents have lost their faith in the government school of teaching. So this is another big reason why we have less number of children going to school. And as far as teaching quality is concerned, people have lost faith as such in the earlier form of education, which is the big reason why there are so many private schools that have come up in Punjab.
These sorts of statistics, would they indicate, you know, it's time that we should have some kind of an insulation as far as the transfer policy of teachers are concerned, insulation from the political pressure, from administrative pressure, which you mentioned rightly?
Well, there's no doubt about it. This is the biggest reason why Captain Amrinder Singh, when he took over, he mentioned that we need to have a transfer policy, which was framed and it was actually approved in March. In March, it was approved and then this is followed by agitation by the teachers because of different reasons. One was that the new teachers who will be recruited will not be paid more than 10,000 for 3 years. That was one. But the other important thing that the teachers were protesting was that a clause which said that a teacher will be transferred after every 7 years, which was opposed primarily on the ground that teaching is not like any other office job. Even traditionally, teachers are known to be sticking to one place for very long periods. So this was the big reason why this shift has happened.
And what's the kind of, they have as you mentioned in March, they had this draft policy. Why is it becoming so difficult to implement this? Are there political pressures?
After March, what happened, it was followed by a teacher agitation, which happened during the parliamentary elections to Shahkot. Purely because of political pressure, the matter was put off the shelf. And it again came up in July. And in July again, it was told to the minister, was communicated that the policy needs to be redrafted. So they're working on it, so which means, and it was announced that the policy will be implemented this year onwards. Now, since it's off the shelf, it purely means that there'll be no policy this year. It has been put off. So even earlier, the policy first time was mentioned way back in 2003. And it was told that the transfers will be done by the DEOs at the district level, circle officers at the circle level, and by the DPI at the senior level. After that, there was another policy which came in 2011, in which it was said that no transfer of teachers will be made outside the cities or towns where they were, in case there was a place in some other schools. They could be shifted only if all the seats were full. Removing different anomalies, the current thing came up. Now, what the policy basically is saying, that teachers will be evaluated on a scale of 200 marks, out of which 85 will be for the length of service, for the quality of service. 50 marks will be for special, some special conditions like if it's a female or if it's a handicapped. And 15 marks will be given specially to teachers who put their wards in their own schools. So on a parameter of 200 marks, transfer of teacher will be decided. This has been proposed in the latest policy.
And going back to your story about these 226 kids without any school teachers, how are they managing?
Currently, a large amount of management in this category of schools is being done by temporary teachers. Now, for such a big strength, for so many classes, if it's a primary, there are five, the middle, the more, three in that immediate classes, it's not possible for one teacher to teach all the classes, you can easily understand. So, a teacher who's there on a temporary basis is just managing the crowd, that's it. So, basically, there's no education there.
Thank you so much, Sanjeev. So, clearly, you have, as Sanjeev mentioned, quite a lopsided policy. In fact, a transfer policy which, in a draft which is already pending, still in the process of being implemented. And perhaps a need for more insulation from the political pressure as far as the transfer policies are concerned. That's all we have for you on this special broadcast. Thanks for watching.